Hello and welcome to an all-new Ardawen Tries Borderlands 2. But Ardawen, you can eat them. Well, no, fuck you. So I've been trying out Borderlands 2, the sequel of the successful game Borderlands. Now let me first say that I really enjoyed the first Borderlands, which was something special because I normally do not like games that involve aiming and shooting because I suck at it. But Borderlands and its DLC was different, and I really really enjoyed it for many many hours. And even though the ending was kind of a disappointment, I really looked forward to Borderlands 2, and there it is, Borderlands 2. Well, let's talk about it, shall we? So Borderlands 2 starts off 5 years after the first Borderlands, when rumors of an even larger vault spread across the galaxy, and four new vault hunters are lured into a trap by the devious Handsome Jack. But they survive. And the story really dragged me in, and I felt really, really involved, even more so than the first one. I felt even so involved in the story that, without giving away any spoilers, I actually felt betrayed at a specific point. And that's a good thing, because that's how much the story dragged me in and made me involved with what was going on, and I thought it was really good. Handsome Jack is a monster. He is freaking hilarious, but he's a monster. I do not lie if I say that I had moments that I was a little bit horrified about the things he said to you through the echo device. So there are definitely some improvements story-wise. For example, they review a few things that were actually going on in the first part and between the parts, and it's definitely better than the first part, and I really really enjoyed the story so far. Now let's take a look at the world you're walking around in. In many ways, Pandora feels like Pandora, in a sense that you get the perfect mix of people and enemies you remember, and people and enemies that are new. Like your old pals, Scooter, Moxie, Markers, Crazy Ed, Dr. Zed, and Claptrap will be there. But you will meet up with some new friends, like my personal favorite, Tiny Tina. A rather unusual 13-year-old girl with a rather special kind of humor. I'm telling you, you would love her tea parties. The same goes for the enemies you encounter. The midgets and the skags that we so much love to shoot in the face are still there. But don't you fear, there are still enough newer foes to blast, burn, corrode, shock, or whatever you like. The areas you roam around in are way less the same as in the first part. I'm not even halfway through the game, and I was already pleasantly surprised about this part of Pandora we get to see. Ice Blaze and Tundras, for example. For the rest, I have to say again that Pandora feels like Pandora, in a good way. Meaning that even though the climate and the areas changes, and you do encounter newer and deadlier foes, you do not feel like you're on a completely new planet. The last thing I want to say about the world we walk around in is that there is even a hidden area that's a tribute to a game we all so well know and so well love. I know I do. Now on to the gameplay. So far I only played with the Gunzerker, and oh boy did I loved playing with the Gunzerker. The dual wield skill of the character brings a lot of fun, and the sounds the character makes reminded me a little bit of my old neglected dwarf champion from Lord of the Rings Online. And that's a good thing. Except the panting during the running. that was all fun and games the first few times I heard it, but eventually it started to get a little bit creepy. Both solo mode and co-op mode is a ton of fun to do. I did it one time with one other person and one time with two other persons, and joining in each other's games is really, really easy thanks to the Steam Cloud. Now, is Borderlands 2 the perfect game? Well, no. To me, meeting up with some of the characters of the first game felt rather forced. Like, in the very first beginning of the game, the claptrap that happens to find you and happens to be the only claptrap in the entire planet of Pandora that is left just happens to be the same annoying piece of scrap metal that helped you the first time. Story-wise, we are supposed to believe that we are even more powerful than the previous Vault Hunters. Well, normally that wouldn't be a problem, but we spent so much time and so much effort in of characters in the first game that were those previous Vault Hunters, that it kind of felt like an insult to my time spent in the first game, and I couldn't get over that. Even though the gameplay has its upsides, sometimes it feels a bit weird, especially in dying mode when some mobs seem to be in me, and another mob, that's one specific mob that's dragging me to his side while he's not aiming at me. It feels poorly constructed and weird, even though it might have a reason. The gameplay issue really was a bit of a letdown to me, and it annoyed the hell out of me. But in the end, Borderlands 2 is a worthy sequel to its predecessor, and there are definitely some major improvements. I really liked it, and I enjoyed the hell out of it, and that's why I'm giving it a 7.5 out of 10. Well, there it was, folks, the very first game edition of Ardawen Tries. I would like to thank Crowbar and Deathmatic47 for joining me in my endeavors through Pandora. And guys, it has been fun. I hope we can do it again sometimes. I also would like to thank David for pre-reading a script for me. And thank you for watching. Please remember to stop on by on Twitter at Ardawen, or to friend me on Facebook, account name Ardawen, or stop by on my Twitch, Ardawen, and to stop by on my Minecraft server, World of Ardor, and the IP will be below. Goodbye, and I see you all next time on an all new Ardawen Tries. I'm gonna go get